So what is Thinkorswim On Demand? In this video, I'm gonna go over the basics of Thinkorswim On Demand and show you a few tricks to make it a very powerful tool. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps I took to go from trading with a full-time job to trading as a full-time job. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And today, we're going over Thinkorswim On Demand. So what is the on-demand tool? Well, the on-demand tool reverses time and allows you to essentially do anything that you want if you were in that exact moment. Now, the price action doesn't change and move exactly like how it did in real time because this is stored data, but it's really similar. And so this is a powerful way to test strategies in real time if you weren't able to do that in a paper trading account. Before we dive into the program, I want to first say when you're logging in, you might want to increase your RAM usage for Thinkorswim. This will just help when you're using the platform in general. The on-demand feature takes a lot of memory up as well. You're going to want to either increase the RAM usage you have, or sometimes it helps to close out of Thinkorswim in general and restart it. I know I've had issues where on-demand feature is having trouble working, and if I close out of TOS and re-log back in, it'll help a ton. So to increase your RAM usage, just in the login screen, you want to go to the gear down here, and it'll be at the bottom under memory usage. I would suggest increasing that to whatever your computer can handle, because it'll improve your experience in TOS overall and really help with the on-demand system. Once you've selected what you want, just hit save and then log into your account. So when you first log in, the on-demand feature is going to be at the top right of your screen. And when you click on that, it's going to shift your account into a virtual trading account. And it's going to come up here with a few options that you can do. And then you can go up here and you can see that you are given buying power and 100K for essentially virtual trading on this on-demand feature. Now, how this whole system works is you can see at the top right, it is now bring up a date and time. And that's really how you jump around between times and really look at different charts you're wanting to look at and different time frames you're wanting to look at. So if we go to a chart, we can have this on-demand feature and we can tell it to go back to any date we want, even months ago or years ago. Sadly, you can't go in the future, but it still has those dates. But you can go to any month or time in those days and then look at the charts at those times. So if we wanted to go to maybe the 6:30, the market open of a day where maybe we thought that, oh, that was a signal that I could have bought looking back on it. But, you know, hindsight 2020 doesn't always work. And so it's kind of nice to be able to go back into the exact moment and see if, oh, would I have actually taken that trade if I was there? How you do that is if we just wanted to go to, you know, this Monday the 27th, we would make sure we wanted the time to be at exactly 6:30. And then we would click go. And then up here you can see it buffers. I think I pre-buffered this so it was quickly, but sometimes it'll take a long time to buffer it. So you might have to wait a few minutes to buffer the whole chart. Also, if you're buffering a chart of maybe a 5-minute chart, but over 180 days, that's a lot more data than just a 1-minute chart of a whole day. So definitely make sure that you're not charting a huge amount of data or maybe 3 or 4 different charts at a time. It'll take longer and longer. Now, you don't have to be looking at this in a 1-minute chart. You can do it for whatever strategy you're wanting, but just for the sake of this tutorial, and seeing price action move quickly, it's a lot easier to do that on a 1-minute chart. So we can zoom into this 1-minute chart opening candle, and you can see that the price is moving up and down pretty quickly. And price won't always move exactly how it did in real time. But I do wanna stress that, again, this is a simulation, but with real data, it's still a simulation and not the exact same as what trading in the market would really be like. One important thing I think you can really learn from watching this virtual trader is seeing how EMAs move in real time and being able to watch how those work. If you have a trading plan that follows EMAs, an EMA can get changed a lot by, let's say, this huge candle right here. It can be pulled way down. Like, this EMA is all the way down here. And if your strategy is based on an EMA cross, you can get a lot of false readings in real time if you're using that candle and just using this virtual trader and looking at those volatile moments in real time. You can maybe better your understanding and skip out on those fake signals that would have got you into maybe a losing trade, or maybe got you into a winning trade that you would have missed out on. Now, for those of you who also do options, the virtual trader also stores that data. So if you go to the trade tab, you can see that there's the options chain as well. And so you can see what the options pricing is in real time. So maybe if you were going to buy an option, or you were wanting to do a trade a few days ago, and then the price of that stock skyrocketed and you wanted to potentially see what you were going to buy in at and to see how that trade would have worked out, you can go into this virtual trader or on-demand trader and look at the option pricing of that. Again, you can also trade and buy options. So I could just go in here and buy a call on Netflix and get filled at that. And then I can see that I have a position down here of 10 Netflix calls, and I can go to the chart and watch that go up as well with the on-demand feature. Now, really the awesome part about this is just that you have all that data available to look back on, and then you can test all your stuff in real time. If you want to reset either the time, so if I wanted to reset back at 6:30, if I missed that opening, I can go up here and click this reset time, and it will buffer and then reset back at that last date I had. So it actually reset at the last date that it's available and then reset at 6:30. So I can then go back to whatever date I want. Another thing you can reset is your account. So if you blew through all your money, you can go reset account and it will reset up here to that starting 100K for your account. Hey, thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about the Thinkorswim platform or just trading the stock market in general, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you really like this video, make sure to leave it a thumbs up. And as always, if you have any questions or comments, make sure to ask them in the comment section below.